Okay, today we're going to be talking about the real goal behind a lot of the core work that we do. So we have a lot of people that come in that say, I can hold a plank for minutes on end, or I do a lot of ab wheel rollouts. Well, that's good and well if you can do it for a couple minutes, 5 minutes, maybe even an hour. But if we're not getting the proper muscles to engage or sequence properly, we might be actually perpetuating a problem and not working on what we're truly going after with these specific exercises. So the abs kind of get a bad roll, or the rectus abdominis get a bad rap sometimes, because we think they're meant to flex us or go into a crunch or a sit-up position. The true goal of the rectus abdominis is to keep us out of too much lumbar extension or an anti-extension move. So if we're talking about like an ab wheel rollout, I'm going to use a physio ball to demonstrate. What we don't want to see is this first one, so I'm going to do this first one incorrectly. So I'm just going to roll out. If you watch my low back, I'm going to fall into excessive lumbar extension. We call that riding on the spine. So we're approximating the lumbar facets to their maximum ability, which pinches a lot of that soft tissue structures around the facets and the joints in the low back. It can cause an injury, but at the same time, we're actually flying in the face of what we're trying to work on with these movements, which is sagittal plane anti-extension. So if I correctly do this maneuver, the first thing I need to do is get a feel for what's called a posterior pelvic tilt. And that's where I'm letting my hips roll under or tuck under. And to do that, you're going to feel that your glutes have to engage. So now if I go back into the same movement, I'm going to start by contracting my glutes. And now I'm going to get a feel for pushing my hips down to the floor as I go out through this extension movement. And you're going to notice my low back stays nice and neutral. Come back out. A lot of glute engagement, just like a plank should be. Every muscle, front to back, posterior chain, anterior chain, should be engaged. When we're working on something like that with proper sequencing and proper facilitation of all the muscles, then we're getting that anti-extension goal that we're looking for.